Okay, well, if you are terrified of creepy crawler spiders, this next segment may not be for you. Do you want me to change spots with you?
I might need to change spots with you.
Okay, we're talking tarantulas. And right now, their mating season underway here in California. For the next 2 months, the hairy spider will be out and about, especially on popular Mount Diablo State Park, where many of them have already been spotted.
Oh, boy. Tarantulas often misunderstood by those of us who are very scared of spiders. They're not considered a serious threat to humans. And joining us this morning talking about mating season is tarantula hike leader at Mount Diablo State Park, Karen Shackleton, and Harriet, who's right here. I'm like holding my phone because I'm trying to get a picture, and I'm going to put that right there. But I am honestly a little panicked by Harriet.
So there's no reason to be panicked.
Really?
Even though I know that to be true. They are. It's just the visual of them. This is
right.
Harriet's your pet.
Right. So Harriet is actually the park mascot. I'm just her caretaker. I'm lucky enough to actually take care of her and get to love her at home. And Claudine, just put your hand down flat.
Oh, my.
Are you going to do it?
And she's going to do it. Just go flat on the table, Claudine.
Okay.
You can do it. You can do it.
Oh, wait.
All right.
Oh,
and so you're going to feel her.
Oh, my God. I can't even look right now.
And so I'm right here, so nothing's going to happen. So,
Claudine,
Harriet is actually similar in size and temperament to our local spiders.
Okay. Cool.
She's a Chilean rosehair.
Go ahead, Frank.
Absolutely.
She's a Chilean rosehair, so she's a little different. We have a Pana Palmas on the mountain.
Okay. You know, I've done the mountain walk, and I think there's so many things that are so interesting about them. The fact that you can walk on Mount Diablo and really see. We thought we might not see any. We saw so many.
Right.
But two.
See, she likes you, Frank.
She's settling
right down.
Hold on.
So she really likes Frank. That's nice.
We shouldn't be afraid of these, right?
You should absolutely not. So when you're out and about, the tarantulas that you're seeing right now are the males. It's mating season, and they are looking for the ladies.
And what's interesting, when they find the ladies, it doesn't go well for them after they...
Yeah.
Actually, that is not true.
That's not true.
That
widow,
is something that we talk about on our hikes. They do not necessarily eat their males.
Not necessarily.
They can occasionally. If it has been a long time since she's had a meal.
She does like you, right?
How old is Harriet?
Harriet is somewhere around 12 to 15 years old.
Really? So these live a long time.
So the females will live 25 to 30 years. The males that are out are between 3 and 7 years old. They've reached sexual maturity. They have their tibial hooks for mating, and they are out there. And basically, Frank, this is their golden day. This is it. They're done. After this, they're either going to die of predation, exposure, or starvation.
So that's the thing, is that maybe the women, the females don't kill them, but the females typically don't.
So there you go, you can see. They're quick little guys.
Why don't you put him on my shoulder so people can see him a little bit better? But he seems
pretty
happy.
Does he want to be on your
shoulder?
Frank.
The height is a problem for them,
Let me tell you why I'm going to hesitate putting her on your shoulder.
Okay.
So there is one method that they have of defense.
The neck?
Which is flicking these
hairs
on their abdomens. And you don't want to get those in your eyes.
Okay.
Because then you'll end up at the eye doctor.
Good point by you.
Barbed hairs.
What do they eat, by the way?
They eat insects.
Just insects.
Yeah. So Harriet has a very rich diet of big fat crickets.
You know what I think is interesting, too, is that they're very delicate. I mean, they're big and very scary, but they're very delicate. Like, when people are out there, you have to be very careful you don't hold them up high, correct?
Right, exactly. So what we tell people is when you're out and about on the mountain, if you see them, if you absolutely want to feel them crawl across your hand, put your hand flat on the ground.
Which is what we just did, right? We put it flat on the table.
So a wild one, it's okay. It'll crawl up.
We ask that you don't, because sometimes they're a little bit jittery, and you don't want to get the hairs, and they do not bite unless you squeeze them or try to flip them upside down.
Well, you shouldn't do that anyway.
Yeah.
All right,
Karen, this has been fascinating, and you helped me conquer one of my fears.
She held it.
Very
she wasn't going to do that.
Fears.
You did really well, Claudine.
Thank you very much.
Well, important to note, I guess the weekend walks, the hikes are all full. But
they are
this weekend,
full.
But there's more scheduled.
Yes. If you do come out, just please, the best way to capture the wildlife is with a camera.
and
you
not
know,
get close.
Don't try to pick them up because their exoskeletons are fragile. Enjoy
okay.
them. They're gentle. They're beautiful.
They're part of nature.
And have fun.
All right. We have more information on our website at ktvu.com. Look on the Mornings Onto Weblinks section. Karen, thank you so much.